Hello everyone, Iris Franz here. In the next few slides, I'm going to talk about the consumption, investment, government spending, and net export schedules. First, let's take a look at the relationship between GDP and consumption. So using the income approach of GDP, we know that when GDP goes up, it also means that the income of households have been raised. And therefore, if real GDP increases, that means our consumption is also going to be increased. Remember, change in consumption is equal to change in disposable income times MPC. So here is our consumption schedule. You can see the positive relationship between consumption and real GDP. And the slope of the consumption schedule is exactly equal to MPC. So here, consumption is equal to autonomous consumption plus MPC times Y, and Y is our real GDP. If Y goes up, you are going to see a movement along the consumption schedule. So moving from, say, this point to that point, if our real GDP goes up. Suppose your autonomous spending goes up from A to A prime, where A prime is greater than A, then you are going to see a shift of the consumption schedule from this line to that thick line. So that will be a shift in the consumption schedule. Next, we are going to talk about the relationship between real GDP and investment, government spending, and net export. Notice that there is no positive relationship between real GDP and investment or government spending or net export. In fact, investment, government spending, and net export, these are all independent from GDP. First of all, government spending is independent from GDP. Why is that? Because government spending is determined by our Congress. What about investment? Well, investment is also independent from GDP. Why is that? Because investment is determined by our real interest rate. Remember earlier we talked about the investment demand curve. So once your real interest rate is determined, let's say 8%, then firms are going to decide, oh, given that real interest rate is 8%, this is the amount of my investment demand, say 420,000. And once the firms determine that they are going to invest 420,000, then that is determined. So you can see that investment is not determined by real GDP. And net export is also independent of the real GDP. And typically, the US has a negative net export due partially to our strong dollar. And why is the dollar so strong? We're going to talk about that later when we get a chance. Here is a quick recap of the relationship between consumption, investment, government spending, and net export with GDP. First thing first, there is a positive relationship between consumption and GDP. If the real GDP goes up, that means disposable income goes up. That means our consumption will also go up. The other things, be it investment, government spending, or net export, all of this are independent of the real GDP.